Hi guys, today in this video I'm going to show you how to create a batch file to stop and start running services. Thus, you just need to follow these steps. First, we need to open the Notepad, type Windows plus R key, type Notepad, and press Enter. Minimize this Notepad temporarily. And after that, you have to again press Windows plus R key, type services.msc, press enter. And here, as you can see, there is a lot of software is running its background. So with the help of batch file, you can start and stop services. So scroll down. I'll pick one. The software prints spooler, right? Currently is running as background, so double click on it, and you have to copy the service name spooler, open the Notepad, click in the file, type new, open the new file, and you have to type this net start control plus V spooler, press enter, type pause, and click on the file, save as it. I will save in the D drive. You can save any drive now. Type here start, given file name, you should to give the file name start.batch, and click on the save. I'll save this file, choose another location. Let me check what happened. Start.batch, click save. It's now saved D drive. So again, you have to make a new file, click on the Notepad, type here net stop spooler, press enter, then type pause. Again, you have to save this file the same drive, in a D drive. Give the file name stop.batch, and then space, save this file. Open your file explorer. Open the D drive. So there is two batch files. What we need to do? Right click on this file. Just currently the print spooler is running, right? We need to stop this one. You have to click on this batch file stop at, right click on it, run as admin, and as you can see, the print spooler service and we stopped successfully. So we need to double check it stopped or not. Okay, refresh from here. And as you can see, the service is stopped. Before it's running, now it's stopped. So we need to run this software again. Click on the first batch file. Run as administrator. The print spooler service is starting. It successfully. Minimize this. Click on the refresh button, and as you can see, the service is running again. That's it, guys. With this batch file, you can any software program start and stop using the batch file. And before I sign out, please like and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.